All matter is built from 118 essential building blocks known as the elements, and throughout history, many people were set on a path of elemental discovery, while others attempted to create useful ways of organizing them. But it wasn't until 1869 that legendary Russian scientist Dmitri Mendeleev developed an elegant and very useful method, which would later evolve into one of science's most brilliant icons, the periodic table. The periodic table is a super organized collection containing information about each element placed into rows and columns. There are 18 numbered columns on the table that we call groups. These groups are sometimes referred to as families, and like real families, elements in a specific group share some characteristics. For example, elements in group 18 are called the noble gases. These are a collection of elements that are generally very unreactive, like helium in birthday balloons. Next door in group 17, aka the halogens, we find reactive elements that may bond with metals like sodium and potassium to make salts. But what is it that makes different elements share similar chemistry? It's all about the outermost electrons, or the valence electrons. Electrons within atoms are arranged in sets around the nucleus. The set of electrons that is furthest away from the nucleus is the one that interacts with the outermost sets of other atoms, and therefore mostly determines what kinds of chemical reaction that an element does or doesn't do. The periodic table groups elements into columns whose atoms have similar valence electron configurations, and therefore similar chemistry. In the case of the halogens in column 17, each of the elements has 7 valence electrons. The noble gases in column 18 all have 8 valence electrons. Now let's take a look at the rows. Each row is called a period, and like the groups, each row is given a number, this time 1 through 7. Within each period, the valence electron configurations of the elements change from element to element since there are more electrons. As a result, we see the chemistry of the elements changing as well. Remember, a different number of valence electrons means a different chemical reactivity. For example, as we move across the second period, the strength with which an element's nucleus pulls on the element's electrons around it increases. Nuclei of elements on the left side of the table pull relatively weakly, so they are more likely to lose electrons in a chemical reaction. Nuclei of an element on the right pull much more strongly, so they are more likely to gain electrons in a chemical reaction. Periodic, or repeating patterns of physical and chemical properties, are crucial to the organization of the table. These patterns even allowed scientists in the past to predict the properties of as-of-yet-undiscovered elements just by looking at gaps in the table. For example, let's take a look at Mendeleev's original 1869 periodic table. See this hole right here to the right of aluminum? Mendeleev predicted that an element that was similar to aluminum existed, but had not yet been discovered. He called it eca-aluminum. When gallium was discovered a few years later, Mendeleev's predictions about the element's properties proved to be remarkably accurate. In short, the periodic table is more than just a table. It's one of the most useful tools in a chemist's repertoire. It is a masterpiece of data visualization, and its incredible design clearly shows the groups and trends among 118 different elements. Rest assured, its brilliant architecture already has a home prepared for each element that remains, as of yet, undiscovered. Thanks for watching, and make sure to check out the other videos in this series here.